We are here in the southern Dutch town of Valkenburg, where 32 of the world's toughest skaters are about to race head-to-head down the longest ice track ever constructed. These skaters will have to navigate obstacles and hairpin turns at speeds of up to 40 miles an hour as they fight their way to be the first across the finish line. This is Crashed Ice, and you're watching the Red Bull Signature Series. Picturesque town of Valkenburg, and it is cold, 10 degrees cold. But that will not stop these Dutch fans from witnessing the world's best downhill skaters competing in this, the second stop of the 2012 Crashed Ice World Championship. Hey everybody, I'm your host Sal Masekela, and welcome to the Red Bull Signature Series. This year, we'll be bringing you some of the most progressive and innovative sporting events from around the planet, all featured on NBC and the NBC Sports Network. But tonight, we're here for Ice Cross Downhill. And when I say downhill, this is it. The hill behind me, known as the Kauberg, is so steep that it was once made famous as a training stage of the Tour de France. But this is just not a steep hill. It's also the longest ice track ever built, more than 6 football fields long. And with its drops, stairs, and 180-degree turn in the middle, it is a formidable challenge for each and every skater here. For more on that, we'll get straight to the racing. Guys?
Thanks, Sal. The rules are pretty simple. 32 of the best skaters in the world line up 4 at a time to race shoulder to shoulder down the track. The top 2 skaters advance to the next round. Now, it's illegal to intentionally cause another skater to fall, slow down, or leave the course. Right now, let's take a look at some of the features of the largest ice cross downhill track ever built. A frightening 50-degree drop gets things started here in Valkenburg. And then it's a sprint into a tricky step-up rhythm section. Stay in the top 2 if you want to advance and deal with traffic through the Dutch mountains. You want to enter the bridge drop cleanly to prepare for the drop. Keep it wide open through the bank drop and then hold your line through the 180-degree turn of the wedge. Go flat out through the traverse bowl and hang on through the cascading staircase to the finish. At 629 yards, it's the longest crashed ice track ever built. So here we go, round of 32, heat number 1. Alongside Troy Mannering, I'm Todd Harris. We've got 4 skaters, some of the fastest in the world, but we're only taking the top 2 to the next round. If you have to watch out for one guy, I'd say go with the black jersey of Kyle Kroxall, the 23-year-old out of Canada. Michael Prochazka of Czechoslovakia in the silver, Lucas Fiala in the yellow, and Killian Braun in the red. And it is Braun with a great start. He goes out to the lead right away with Kroxall right behind him.
Yeah, you're right, Todd. Killian Braun, great start out of the gate. Look at this, it's opening up, and it is all Killian Braun. He's got the lead at the moment, but he's being chased hard by Kyle Kroxall, who's got that black jersey. Kyle makes a great pass on the outside, but bumps against the wall here. Killian takes over the lead again. Kyle right back on the gas to try and get into that qualifying position. He needs to be second, and Killian Braun right now is owning this race. Kyle Kroxall being hounded by Michael Prochazka and Lucas Fiala.
But it's only the top two that are moving on, and it will be Kilian Braun of Switzerland getting the win, and Kyle Kroxall, who led for much of the race, holds on for second place. Those two men are moving on to the quarterfinals as we go back to the top and take a look at this again.
Now here we go, the all-crucial start into the abyss as they disappear down into that deep hole. And Kilian Braun with such an incredible start. He's been super strong this season, and this event in particular has really showcased his skills. Around the corner, a great move by Kyle Kroxall, but right here, he loses an edge, a little bit too much speed, and Kilian Braun takes over the lead again and never looked back. Kyle Kroxall holding strong as they head towards the steps, and the first two guys across the finish line, as you know, Todd, advance to the next round.
So Kilian Braun gets the victory. He moves on to the quarterfinals, and Kyle Kroxall in the black of Canada will join him there. Great performance by both men. Well, three Americans made the trek to Valkenburg, and 22-year-old Cameron Nass was one of the two that advanced to this round of 32. Nass did it by finishing in second in his first heat. And he was able to knock out two skaters from the Netherlands. ...23-year-old Ty Isaac was the other American who advanced from the round of 64. The Salt Lake City, Utah native did it by finishing in second, just behind crashed ice veteran Marty Niefnecker of Germany. Before Heat 2 gets underway, let's take a closer look at American hopeful Ty Isaac.
Well, you know, I'm on the ice 6 days a week. Morning start, 5:30 every day. Then we've got dry land for an hour after. Then, you know, in most cases, we're back on the ice at 3 o'clock in the afternoon for another hour and a half session.
Ty Isaac, Salt Lake City, Utah.
Coming into speed skating, I thought I was gonna pick it up real quick, like I do everything else. But at the same time, like, there's so much of it that is dependent on absolute perfect technique and strength that you can't build overnight. It takes all that commitment of being there twice a day. You gotta work harder than everybody else on the team. Yeah, I mean, there is always, you know, the ever-changing factor of the human being. No race is ever the same. You know, being able to make and adapt changes within, you know, a few tenths of a second could, you know, make the difference between being first or being 10th. Big thing is confidence. You know, you gotta stay confident on the course. You gotta know that you're gonna be the fastest guy up. The first race, I was just wanting to survive. This next one, I'm out to win.
So here we go, round of 32. This is Heat 2, two Americans in this group, Cameron Nass and Ty Isaac. Kim Mueller will be in the red bib representing Switzerland. Marty Niefnecker of Germany, though, the 22-year-old from the Bavarian Alps in Garmisch, Germany, has looked so very fast. Keep an eye on him.
Well, like you said, Todd, Niefnecker, the world champion from 2010, really taking on this course. Great style for him this year. He's riding a lot more relaxed. He's not putting so much pressure on him. Kim Mueller right behind Niefnecker. Unfortunately, Ty Isaac and Cameron Nass just not quite able to keep up as Cameron goes hammering himself into the boards. Coming to the horseshoe, Niefnecker still out in front. Kim Mueller from Switzerland chasing him hard. Ty Isaac still doing his best to catch up to the two leaders, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen.
And you're right, Marty Niefnecker of Germany in the blue across the finish line. The top two moving on to the quarterfinals. And unfortunately, Ty Isaac has been eliminated. Niefnecker of Germany and Kim Mueller of Switzerland are moving on as we go back and look at this again.
We can see here a fantastic start by all of the guys, but it was Niefnecker and Mueller who just had the advantage, and you can see Niefnecker tucking up over that one step up jump after the abyss. All of the guys making it clean.
So here's how it goes. Marty Niefnecker of Germany moving on, as is Kim Mueller. They are into the quarterfinals. Unfortunately, the Americans eliminated. They're standing by with Sal.
Because you guys don't have the opportunities to practice the way the Europeans do, how do you get around that? What do you guys do to be able to prepare yourselves heading into Sweden?
I'm just going to go out and skate as much as I can. I know these guys are going to be going to camp in Ari or in Aura, and they're going to be out on the track, so that'll be a big help for us.
I think a lot of this, like you said, you know, we're going to be at that camp next week for 6 to 8 days. But most of it, I think, is really a lot of a mental game, getting yourself ready, getting yourself prepared to go down these nasty courses and go as fast and hard as you can.
Thank you, Sal.
See you there.
Good luck, guys.
Thanks, Sal. Better luck to the Americans at Åre, Sweden. We'll be right back with more of the Crashed Ice World Championship from Valkenburg. For more information on the Signature Series and some great content, check out RedBullSignatureSeries.com. This is the round of 32, heat number 3, and the man in the golden fleece, R2 Pilainen of Finland, extremely fast. In the blue, Lari Jutsenlahti of Finland as well. He finished in 7th place in our first event at St. Paul, but Peter Geisel and Philip Alzerwald also in this one as well. 4 men battling for 2 spots in the quarters. And a great start by Pilainen.
Oh, the Dutch mountains, not a favorite area for R2P Leinen, but the current world champion navigating them quite easily, and he is being chased hard by Peter Geisel from Belgium. So a Finn out in front holding on to the lead here, and he is really doing his best to try and get some points under his belt here in Valkenburg in the Netherlands as Peter Geisel is battling hard with Lari Jutsenlahti. It is all R2P Leinen, that great start for him and into the big air.
Well, the defending champion is out in front, P. Leinen, last year's world champion, and at the finish line, what a finish! Lari Jutsenlahti comes from 3rd place to grab the 2nd transfer position. So the Finns go 1 and 2, and Geisel on the outside looking in. Let's go back to the top and look at this again.
There you see Jutsenlahti focusing hard on trying to stay on his feet, but he just has some trouble. Hip checks Philip Alzerwald from Germany, and that puts Alzerwald out, and Jutsenlahti battling hard with Peter Geisel here. Incidental contact, it's okay to do that as long as you don't hinder the other skater by grabbing and pulling or T-boning against the boards. And here is the advantage going to Jutsenlahti. He just gets the speed down the steps. This one was all R2P Leinen, but Jutsenlahti with a great effort to finish off in 2nd place, and he advances to the quarterfinals with R2.
So the two Finns moving on, Pilainen and Jutsenlahti. R2P Leinen is among the elite when it comes to racing, and that got us thinking, what are the perfect athlete specs for an ice cross downhill racer? Sal Masekela breaks it down.
When people see Red Bull crashed ice, they often think to themselves, there's no way I'd ever do that. So what does it take to hurl yourself down a downhill ice cross track? What does it take to win? What defines the perfect crashed ice athlete? Is it all brawn, or does gray matter come into play? If Team USA were building the perfect athlete, what would they want? Ty Isaac's headspace, committed, crack of dawn training, 2-a-days on the ice. To get you ahead of the pack, you'd want to add the quick feet of Cameron Nas. Then mix in the linebacker physicality of Andrew Bergeson to hold off any approaching passes. That would be tough to beat. And if we can build a super athlete, so can they, right? You could take the size and fitness of Canadian Kyle Croxall, the quick acceleration of brother Scott Croxall. Maybe add in the ability to pump the track like Switzerland's Kilian Braun. Top it off with the tenacious game face and will to win of Pitbull R2P Leinen. Sure, it would be nice to mix and match. But here in the real world, there's no perfect superhuman crashed ice athlete. Or is there?
That's a good question, Sal. There is a look at the 3rd member of Team USA, Andrew Bergeson, unable to advance to the finals here in Valkenburg after injuring his shoulder in the qualifying round. We move on in the round of 32. Heat number 7 locked and loaded. Scott Croxall, the younger brother of Kyle Croxall, who's already made it into the quarterfinals. Jim DePaoli of Switzerland, 23 years of age. He finished 8th at our last stop in St. Paul. Also, Haywood of Canada and Kurnikov of Russia in this one as well. Once again, the start is key.
Well, as we said, in St. Paul, we saw that Scotty Croxall was really looking great out of the gate, and it is the exact same thing here in Valkenburg. He takes the whole shot and just opens up the lead. It is unbelievable how quick he is. The other Canadian in the mix here, Colton Haywood in blue, going down there in the corner, gets passed by the Swiss man, Jim DePaoli, who moves into second place. Colton's got his work cut out for him to catch up with Jim at this point as they head towards the big drop.
So it's Croxall leading the way in the red. DePaoli of Switzerland in the yellow. Top two are moving on to the quarterfinals. Great action. And down at the finish, leaving no doubt about it, Scott Croxall of Canada, Troy, dominated, got the whole shot, and just blew the rest of the field away.
So you can see here Scott with some great position as they come around the corner, and that's where Colton Haywood, he toe-picked and just couldn't come back from it. Scott with some style over the jump, as well as Jim DePaoli taking it clean, and Colton Haywood just not on it today. Just got shaken up there, couldn't quite come back with it. Scotty Croxall and Jim DePaoli moving on to the next round.
So the quarters are set. Canada and Switzerland, their skaters are moving on. We'll be right back with more of the Crashed Ice World Championship from Valkenburg after this. Welcome back to the Netherlands for stop number 2 of the Crashed Ice World Championship. Here's a look at the athletes who have advanced to the quarterfinals. Heat number 1, Kyle Croxall looks fast as usual. Heat number 2, R2P Leinen of Finland, the defending world champion. Heat 3 is stacked, and heat number 4, keep your eye on the other Croxall, Scotty Croxall. As the guys head up to the top for the quarterfinals, let's take a look back at the first stop of the 2012 Crashed Ice World Championship.
St. Paul, Minnesota. First stop of the Crashed Ice World Tour. The men to beat, defending world champion R2P Leinen from Finland, and the Canadian Wonder Brothers, Kyle and Scott Croxall. American Cameron Nas led the early charge, skated fast out of the start, and held on for a second place finish in his heat to move on. 24-year-old Minnesota hometown boy Andrew Bergeson fought hard and also moved on to the round of 32. U.S. speed skater Ty Isaac took advantage of strong skating and a little luck to earn a berth into the next round. But the fast and experienced competition and the St. Paul track were too much. No Americans would advance past the round of 32. The finals featured two Canadians and two Finns, the Croxall brothers versus R2P Leinen and Pavel Klintra. Croxall would not look back and earn his first win of the season. R2 battled back and edged out Scott Croxall to take second. Who'll be popping bottles in Valkenburg? We're about to find out.
St. Paul was wonderfully out of hand and amazing. But remember, Crashed Ice, really only one of the events in the Red Bull Ticketer Series, a television series unlike anything ever attempted.
Conceived by the athletes themselves, the Red Bull Signature Series places the planet's most fearless athletes center stage. Over 20 of the most progressive and innovative competitions in countries all over the globe unleashed in one epic series. Supernatural, backcountry filming and competition merge in the most spectacular snowboarding run ever crafted. Mountain biking pushes to new extremes as freeriders chart the uncompromising terrain of Red Bull Rampage. In Cold Rush,
skiers confront harrowing drops in the high alpine cliffs of the Rockies. And the collective energy of thousands surges in the mother of all freestyle motocross events, Red Bull X Fights. Prepare to believe in the unbelievable as these athletes attempt to make the impossible possible. Red Bull Signature Series is the evolution of sports. Watch all year long on NBC and the NBC Sports Network. Go to RedBullSignatureSeries.com for complete schedule details.
Welcome back, friends. We are in the midst of the quarterfinals, and about to drop in is the Crash Dice St. Paul winner, Kyle Croxall. Let's find out what fuels this powerhouse in Ice Cross Downhill.
A typical day out here is pretty much me working at the fire hall.
Another great start for Croxall. Just a super solid skater.
Crash Dice has become a huge part of my life. I'm training all year round now, training in the summer to keep myself going, training hard in the winter, playing lots of hockey and lots of conditioning.
He comes around those corners, and that's one of the areas where he's so strong.
I'm not happy about last year's results. I can beat him. I'm going to be aiming for that this whole year.
Kyle Croxall chasing R2 hard. R2 makes the small mistake. And both of them go down. Kyle Croxall gets back up.
Being a firefighter on a daily basis and then getting to travel all across the world, I'm just going to keep doing what I've been doing and do the best I can.
A busy man with his focus now on quarterfinal number one. Killian Braun will be in the red bib representing Switzerland. Kyle Croxall in the black out of Canada. Marty Niefnecker's here, as is Kim Mueller of Switzerland. The start is key.
The battle between Kyle Croxall and Marty Niefnecker continues to rage, but this one really belongs to Killian Braun. Surprising how good he's been looking this event. Out in front, Kyle Croxall right there with him. Marty Niefnecker sitting in third place with the yellow jersey at the moment as they head towards a very tricky section. Big left-hander and then to the horseshoe, the big righty. A 180-degree turn they have to make. Croxall and Braun out in front leading this one longwise.
Killian Braun of Switzerland in the red, out in front. There you see the pursuit for second place. It's just not gonna happen for Marty Niefnecker. So Braun of Switzerland gets the win. Kyle Croxall of Canada grabs second place in the black bib, and those two men are moving on to the semis. Remember, Kyle Croxall won our first event in St. Paul, Minnesota, as we go back to the top of the course to see how this thing got going.
Well, his jersey absolutely says it all. If you want to be second, follow me. But in this case, Killian Braun had the better start. Marty Niefnecker was there, but had a small problem right at that step-up jump and never quite recovered for it. He hung back in third place, wasn't able to catch up with Killian Braun and Kyle Croxall, and those two guys advanced to the semifinals.
So they collect their breath as they make their way back to the top of the course. Killian Braun winning the first quarter final. Croxall will join him in the semis. Quarterfinal number two in the gate, ready to go. Fabian Melz will be in the red. He's out of Germany. R2P Leinen, the defending champion in the Golden Fleece. And keep an eye on the blue, a fellow countryman from Finland, Lari Jutsenlahti. Another great start for P Leinen.
Well, Todd, I gotta tell you, R2P Leinen looks like he's been struggling a little bit with the course today, but this one looks really good for him as he's out in front. But Fabian Melz from Germany making a great move there on the inside, and he takes the tulip drop in the lead with R2P Leinen wondering what's happened to his speed out of the gate as he has a lot of trouble navigating through that abyss. And here they come towards the horseshoe with Melz holding off the world champ.
And it looks like right now the world champ content to hold on to second place. He is getting pressure from behind from the Russian Andrei Lavrov as they come down the final few features of the staircase. Lavrov is out of it, but at the line, it will be Fabian Mels of Germany in the red bib, just edging out the defending world champion, R2 Pilainen. No harm there, because remember, the top two moving on, so those men safely advancing on to the semifinals as we go back to the top of the course.
Great start by all of the guys out of the gate. The usual good start there by R2 Pilainen, but it just seems to shake him up a little bit going through that abyss. A good battle by Fabian Mels to move into position. He actually had better position, and his long legs were the advantage in this heat. And with a 600 meter long course, you're definitely talking about those long legs being an advantage.
No question about it, Troy, as they come to the end, you see just how close this was. Fabian Mels holding off the defending champion. So one semifinal is set, but we've got more quarterfinal action coming up. We'll be right back with more of the Crashed Ice World Championship from Valkenburg, the Netherlands.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. This is Crashed Ice. Find out what everybody's talking about. Join the Signature Series conversation by following us on Facebook and Twitter. Let's get back to the racing with Todd Harris and Troy Mannering.
All right, thank you, Sal. We are set for quarterfinal number three. Keep your eye on LPD, Louis P. Dumoulin. Also, Adam Horst, the third fastest in qualifying, with a great start here.
Well, definitely right, Todd. Adam Horst was third fastest in the qualifying, but you know what? That doesn't really count for much when you come down to four-on-four racing here. And what you got here is Louis-Philippe Dumoulin taking control of this race, not going for the style points on course, just trying to take up as much space as he can and block out Adam Horst, who he knows is quick. The other two guys, Andreas Ruga and Derek Wedge, having trouble going into the boards, knocking each other down. Derek Wedge there in the silver with the dreadlocks, getting up quicker and trying to hunt these first two guys down, but it's not gonna happen as Derek Wedge nails the boards again.
Canada's LPD out in front in the blue. In second place, Adam Horst, also of Canada. And remember, the top two are moving on, and it will be the Canadian duo. Louis P. Dumoulin wins it. Adam Horst holds on for second place, so the Canadians have two more in to the semifinals.
So you can see Adam Horst in the red jersey there, really focusing on trying to get into a good position. He knows that Louis-Philippe Dumoulin is a big boy, and when he gets out in front, he is impossible to pass. LPD does a great job of blocking on the course, good body position, holds his lines really well, and there you can see the mistake of trying to change your line in the middle of the race. These two guys, both the Swiss men, eliminated, but having fun at the finish, both of them with 360s.
A little bit of style there from the Swiss skaters, but it is the Canadians moving on as the Maple Leaf puts two more into the semis. All right, we continue with the quarterfinals. This is the fourth and final one. Four men battling for two spots, the final two in the semifinals. And Scott Croxall's got to be the odds-on favorite, Troy. The man in red, 21 years of age. And remember, he's the younger brother of Kyle Croxall, finishing third in our first event in St. Paul. The start is so very key, and Croxall with a great one. Give him the whole shot as the Canadians out in front.
Absolutely a great start for Scott Croxall. He's been so strong out of the gate. I've been saying that all day long. He looks great this year. Pavel Klintrup also was on the podium in St. Paul. He is looking to get back in that position. He liked the taste of being up there, but he goes down. Oh, he has some trouble, but we saw Pavel get right back up super fast, and he is chasing down Scotty Croxall. Scotty's got a huge lead, and right now the battle is for second place between Mika Jukkamainen in yellow and Pavel Klintrup in blue. The two Finns not holding anything back. Pavel Klintrup coming out better over the big air towards the steps.
Scott Croxall out in front. He'll get the win, and at the line, it will be the blue bib of Pavel Klintrup. So the two Finns battling for one spot in the semi. Scott Croxall left nothing to be questioned there. He dominated, but the Finns battle it out for second.
Look at this start right here. Scotty Croxall, super out of the gate. Absolutely fantastic. Getting to the pedals. And here is Pavel Klintrup in blue. He's not able to catch Scotty Croxall, the big boy from Canada, just too strong. But the very quick-footed Pavel Klintrup holding on to it. Right here, he almost lost it to Jukka Mäkinen. A great battle between the two Finns there. And that's really where this race was all about, the battle for second place. But it was Klintrup in the end, moving on with Scotty Croxall.
So the second fastest in qualifying, Scott Croxall is moving on. He's taking Pavel Klintrup of Finland with him. The semifinals are now set. And what a group of eight we've got here in Valkenburg. Some of the fastest on the planet, headlined by the defending champion, R2P-Linen. And the Croxall brothers are definitely a force to be reckoned with. Who will move on to the final? We'll have that when we return with more of the Crashed Ice World Championship from Valkenburg. Semi-final number one set to go. You want to talk about talent. Fabian Mels will be in the blue. Kyle Croxall will be in the black. And there you got to look at the red bib of Killian Braun. But that man, R2P-Linen, so extremely fast out of the gate. And once he gets out in front, he is hard to track down. But you got to bet that Kyle Croxall in the black bib, the 23-year-old out of Ontario, will do his best. And it's the 21-year-old Fabian Mels from Cologne, Germany, who gets the big lead.
And Kyle Croxall just sneaking in to second place with Killian Braun, who's been super strong today, moving into third place. Surprisingly, R2P-Linen bringing up the rear. He has got his work cut out for him to try and catch up to these big boys out front. Three giant skaters leading this one with Fabian Mels from Germany. The surprise dark horse this weekend has been absolutely phenomenal. Kyle Croxall not letting him get too far away.
And it's three men now battling for two spots in the final. R2P-Linen on the outside looking in. And R2P-Linen amazingly has been eliminated. What a finish as Kyle Croxall and Fabian Mels will move on. Remember, it's the skate that has to cross first, and it looks like P-Linen was edged out.
Well, there you see the legs of Kyle Croxall coming out of that gate, taking the first few strides to get into the abyss. He was not as quick as Fabian Mels. Fabian Mels definitely had the advantage in the takeoff out of the gate, and right there, he just kind of took the whole thing home. The so short line across the Dutch mountains gets him the advantage, and he never really let that go. He knew Kyle Croxall, who is a very strong glider, was chasing him down, and you could see Killian Braun not too far away, and R2P-Linen also still in the mix here. This was the closest race of the day with all four guys pretty much coming to the chute.
And at the line, look at this. Fabian Mels in the blue, keep an eye on the skate. And it is Kyle Croxall who just edges out the defending world champion right there. R2P-Linen has been eliminated. So P-Linen very frustrated, but it is Mels and Croxall. Those two are into the final. One Croxall is in, will the other join him? Scotty Croxall, the younger brother of Kyle, awaits at the top of the course. This is semifinal number two. Four men battling out for two spots in the final. There is Pavel Klintrup, the 22-year-old, born in Helsinki. In the red bib, keep your eye on Scotty Croxall, 21 years of age, the younger brother of Kyle. And the Canadians are out in force here in the Netherlands. Adam Horst and LPD, so three Canadians and one Finn, and with a great start, it's Scott Croxall.
Well, Scotty Croxall went through the Dutch Mountains pretty clean. Pavel Klintrup absolutely gambled everything, going for the big gap, and it worked for him. He's moved into second place here with Louis-Philippe Dumoulin from Canada bringing up third place, and he is chasing Klintrup hard. Louis-Philippe Dumoulin, disappointed in St. Paul, wants to get back on the podium, and his only opportunity is getting out of these semifinals, but Pavel Klintrup not letting him get through. Scotty Croxall dominating this one as he goes over the big air, and that looks like it's going to be the way for him all the way to the finish.
Scotty Croxall leaving no doubt about it, bringing it home. He's into the semis where his brother awaits, and Pavel Klintrup with some sketchy skating at the bottom, Troy, stayed on his feet to the finish, and he'll grab the other transfer position.
Well, Todd, this was another great race, but again, Scotty Croxall with a fantastic entrance into the course. Pavel Klintrup struggling a little bit to catch up, but look at this right here as they head towards the Dutch Mountains. A massive jump by Klintrup gave him that momentum that he needed on the inside line. He squeaks himself into second place with LPD chasing him hard. LPD had it almost until he lost an edge with a toe pick right there, and he left it all to Pavo heading towards the finish. So it's going to be Scotty Croxall and Pavo Klintrup advancing to the final.
Well, Troy, the final is now set, and what a final it will be. The two Canadians, Scotty and Kyle Croxall, are in the final. Fabian Melz of Germany has been extremely fast all night, and Pavo Klintrup, the lone Finn who gets in there. Sal standing by with a very disappointed R2P line.
R2P, that was a tough semifinals race, very, very close. Take us through that race. What happened?
I knew this track was, I couldn't use my strength at the start because it was so steep. So I was struggling a little bit at the start. Then I doubled the Dutch mountains, get good speed from that, but then I did a little mistake before the jump, step-up jump, and lost the guys for 5 meters. And then it was really hard. I was pushing so hard, could get past Killian in the corner, and then I was pushing like hell to the last jump and almost got Kyle, but I was too far away.
All right, so heading into to Sweden, how do you focus? What are your goals?
We'll see about the track there. It's gonna be fast, I know that, so. Well, we're hopefully in the finals.
All right. Well, all the best to you, my friend.
Thank you.
All right.
So the defending champion has been knocked out, but four extremely talented and fast skaters remain. We'll be right back with more of the Red Bull Crashed Ice World Championship after this.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. This is what it's all about. We're going to crown a champion here at Crashed Ice Valkenburg. The Croxall brothers, Pavel Klintrup and Fabian Wells are all set into the final. We'll go back to the racing with Todd with the call.
Thank you, Sal. As you can see and feel, it is extremely cold. But right now, no one is thinking about how cold it is. Pavel Klintrup is thinking about getting the Finnish flag on the top of the podium. Two Canadians, one German and one Finn.
Greetings to all my German and Friesish fans. Team Croxy, baby, let's go 1-2. Woo!
Well, you've got to give the advantage to Team Croxall. Brothers racing right next to each other. In the black is Kyle Croxall, and he was the winner of our first event in St. Paul. He's got his younger brother, Scotty Croxall, to his left. This is it, the big final from Valkenburg.
Amazingly, Fabian Melz does it again with the hole shot. He's been incredible all weekend long. Scotty Croxall in the back of the pack right now with Kyle Croxall passing Fabian Melz when he went down in the faceplant. Fabian got back up and was lucky that Scotty Croxall just crashed into the wall there. Now he's slowing down as Pavel Klintrup comes hard around the outside and passes Croxall, who's sitting way in back. Kyle Croxall out in front in the black jersey. Fabian Melz from Germany in blue right behind him as they head towards the shoot to the big air, and it is all Kyle Croxall over the big air.
Kyle Croxall absolutely dominating the race, Troy. He brings it home two in a row. Croxall wins the first event, claims the second here in Valkenburg.
Heading to the final.
What a great performance by all four of our finalists, and you can see why Crashed Ice is that exciting. It is not over until it's complete as we go back to the top of the course to see how this thing got going.
All right, well, you can see the start here, Todd. Scotty Croxall has been so good out of the start, and Fabian Mel's right there with him. And in fact, the mistake by Scotty Croxall at the step-up jump was what cost him the position. Fabian Mel's really played it well. Pavel Klintrup feeling confident with that double at the Dutch Mountains, goes for the big jump. Doesn't quite work out for him that time like it did the last time around. We can see it again here. And he goes down for the belly flop right here where they really need to stay on their feet. Kyle Croxall keeps the good line. Fabian Mel's chasing him down. Here comes Pavel Klintrup and Scotty Croxall bringing up the rear, and that's obviously where he had the problem with his blade because you don't see him going for it hard, and it is the winner. Kyle Croxall padding his score once again and moving into the third event in Sweden with 2,000 points in his box.
Let's check in now with Sal Masekela.
Kyle Croxall, second champagne bath in a row, my friend. Congratulations. Take us through that final.
It was a crazy final. I mean, pretty much our semifinal was the final, and then we had the final with all top guys again. So it was two tough races. Started out as fast as I could, came out in second, and made the pass at the second jump. So from there on, I was just trying to stay out front.
What's your goal as we head into RA now? You are the man with the target on your back. Obviously, it's going to put a little bit of pressure on yourself. How do you stay focused for the goal of winning this overall championship?
I mean, going into this one, it was a little bit of a load off the shoulders coming in first. So another win here puts another load off the shoulders. So I'm just trying to stay focused and go for the win again.
All right. Well, Canada definitely showing an advantage this season, man. Congratulations to you.
Oh, thanks a lot.
All right.
Here is a look at the final results from Valkenburg. Canadian Kyle Croxall gets the victory, holding off German Fabian Mels. Pavel Klintrup of Finland grabs third, and Scotty Croxall finishes in fourth despite the broken blade. And the Crashed Ice World Championship rankings look like this. After two stops, Kyle Croxall 2-for-2. Fabian Mels sits in second, the defending champion R2P Leinen in third, and Scott Croxall in fourth. ...21-year-old German skater Fabian Mels is the focus of today's signature moment. Facing off against the best two ice cross downhill skaters in the world, Mels was not only able to take the whole shot, but hold off Croxall and Pelainen on his way to taking the win in semi-final number one. Congratulations to the young German. We'll look forward to seeing him in Sweden.
Man, what a great night of competition, huh? Valkenburg definitely delivering for the second year in a row. I look forward to seeing you guys in Åre, Sweden for our third stop of the Crashed Ice World Championship. And then it's on to the mecca of ice cross downhill, Quebec, Canada, where we will crown our champion. Thanks for joining us tonight. On behalf of the entire NBC Sports crew, I'm Sal Masekela. Good night.